Good morning students. Today now we are going to topic about transportation in plants and circulation in animals. So already teached the some few topics I will teach you. Remaining few topics today I will teach you. Okay. Listen carefully. First one topic is of transpiration. Transpirations yesterday I told. Repeat again one times. The water eventually is released to the atmosphere as vapor viva. The plant stomato, tiny closable pore like structures on the surface of leaves. Okay, this position of root systems, this is position, and then only evaporations. Okay, root systems of heating absorbed in underground waters, that is underground waters heat absorb, and evaporation of some waters. Okay, this uptake of water at the roots, transport of water through plants tissues, and release of vapor by leaves is known as transpirations. Okay, transpiration. Then transpirations next, remainings of condensation, that condensations in sky. Okay, then only precipitations of in the land. So rotations of soil, solid and liquid and gas stages of transpirations. Okay, next one. What five factors affect the rate of transpiration for plants? So factors affecting of transpirations, two into divided two parts, that is external parts and internal parts. Okay, external part and internal part. Internal part, it is a inside parts. So external part, it is a outside parts, outside and inside. Okay, internal spot and outernal parts. Okay, internal and external. Then only first, transpiration is affected by several external factors, such as temperature, light, humidity and wind speed. This is called as external factors. Internal factors that affect the transpiration include number and distributions of stomato. So percentage of open stomato, water status of the plant, canopy structures, examples of canopy structures of etc. Okay, these leaves, leaf sides, open side place of stomato. Okay, opened, that is stomato. So stomato open, inside some more parts of the inside, nucleus, vacuole and cell wall and stomato and chloroplast. Okay, so more in the parts of the insides of factors affecting of transpirations. Okay, then only signification of transpirations. Creates transpirational full for transport of water, supplies waters for photosynthesis. Main reasons of photosynthesis of supplies water, transport minerals from soil to all parts of the plant, cools the surface of the leaves by evaporation, keeps the cells drenched, hence maintains their shape. Okay, well, this is a function of transpiration. Okay, next one, root pressure. Root pressure, yeah, mineral ions from the soil are actively transported into xylem tissue of the root. Water moves along and increase the pressure inside the xylem. This pressure is called root pressure and is responsible for pushing water upward to some extent. Next one, uptake of minerals by plants. Uptake of minerals by plants. Plants depend on minerals from soils for it is nutritional requirements. All minerals cannot be passively absorbed by the roots. Two factors account for this. Minerals are present in the soil as charged particles, ions, okay, that cannot move across cell membranes, and the concentration of minerals in the soil usually lower than the concentration of minerals in root, in the root. Therefore, most minerals enter the root by active absorption through the cytoplasm of epidermal cells. So needs energy in the forms of ATP. Then it is transported for all parts by transpiration flow. Okay, some examples of the uptake of nutrients occurs at both the root and leaves. Okay, uptake of nutrients, root and leaves. Okay, so both side, root and leaves, both side uptake of nutrients occurs. Okay, next one, water and minerals. Water and minerals, some examples of water. Put the waters regularly in our gardens. So downside of underground, underground side, pour the water. So H2O, so water formula of H2O, then only minerals, H2O and minerals and oxygen. Oxygen, O2 oxygen and CO2 carbon dioxide. Okay, so oxygen and carbon dioxide. Leaf sides of nutrients, that is underground sides of minerals and nutrients. Nutrients, that is carbon dioxide and waters and oxygen. So okay, carbon dioxide man breathing of carbon dioxide outside and oxygen inside, and plants breathing of outside of inside of carbon dioxide and outside of oxygen. Okay, so man using of repeat using of plant. Okay, so man and man using of oxygen and carbon dioxide, breathe in and breathe out, and plant carbon dioxide breathe in and oxygen breathe out. Okay, then only accent of sap. Okay, accent of sap, more translation of minerals, ions, some examples of more minerals, ions, okay, phloem transport and translations of sugars and more parts of that nutrients by the plants. Some examples of minerals, remolus leaves, younger leaves. This phenomena can be seen dedicates plants. Elements, phosphorus, sulfur and nitrogen and potassium, so easily mobilized, while element like calcium are not remobilized. Okay, phloem transport food from the source to a sink. The source is part of the plant, that is synthesis of food. Then only translations of sugars. The translocations of sugars from source to sink is through pressure flow. Hypothesis, glucose prepared at source. Okay, it cover two sources. Sucrose moves into the companion cells, then into the living phloem sieve tube cells by active transport. This process product hypertonic conditions in the phloem. Okay, then only accent sap, and it is event and overview. Accent of sap and overview, the upward movement of water. Okay, that is upward movement of water, upward movement of water, and minerals from roots. Okay, minerals from root side. Different plant part, it is called as ascent of sap. Okay, so upward movement of water and minerals from roots, to the upper part of plant body. So upper plant part of plant body, this is called as ascent of sap. Okay, ascent of sap. A number of factors play a role in ascent of sap, and it is take place in following steps. Okay, first one, root pressure. First one, root pressure. Okay, second one capillary action. For this third one, adduction coction of water molecules. These positions of adductions and coctions of water molecules. Next one, cohesion. Okay, cohesions. Next one, cohesions. Cohesion. Then only adduction. Adduction. So transpiration full. Okay, then only transpiration full. Okay, the four parts of root pressure, capillary action, adduction and coction. Then only transpiration of full. Now root pressure, water from soil enter the root care due to the osmosis. So root pressure is responsible for movement of water up to the face of the stem. Okay, capillary action, capillary tube, because physical forces phenomenon is called as capillary action. Water or any liquid rise. Okay, in the same way stem water rise up to certain high because of capillary action. Adduction, the force of attraction between molecules, the different substance is called as adduction. Cohesion, the force attraction between molecules of water is called as cohesion. Cohesion. That is adduction and cohesion. Okay. Transpiration of wool. Through stomato-creative vacuum, which create a suction called transpiration full. Thus, transpiration full sucks the water column from the xylem tubes, and thus water is able to rise to create heights even in the tallest plant. Okay, then only blood. Okay, next one, blood. What is blood? Blood is the main circulatory medium in human body. Blood is the main structures of human body. Blood, it is fluids. Okay, blood, it is fluids. Yeah, fluids solrom appadina thanni madri illama irukradanaala adu or kulu 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 nu irukum. So adha dhaan enna solvanga, fluids. And other animals that delivery necessary substance such as nutrients and oxygen to the cells and transport metabolic waste product away from those same cells. Invertebrates, it is composed of blood cells suspended in blood plasma. What is plasma? Plasma, it is a slightly alkaline containing non-cellular substance which constitutes about 35% of the blood. Organic substance like protein, glucose, urea, enzymes, hormones, vitamins and minerals are present in the plasma. Formed elements of blood. Blood corpuscles are of the three types. Red blood corpuscles and white blood corpuscles and blood platelets. So red blood corpuscles are BC. And WBC, white blood corpuscles, and then only blood platelets, thrombocytes. Okay, thrombocytes. So red blood capsules, so erythrocytes, RPC cells, they are most abundant cells in the human body. RPC are formed in the bone marrow. The RBC import red color to the blood due to the presence of respiratory pigment hemoglobin. That is examples of hemoglobin. Hemoglobin. Okay, that is blood is this was fluids. Fluids. Okay, then only blood it is a WBC. RBC and blood plate. Okay, so then only white blood blood corpuscles they have do not have hemoglobin or nucleated cell. It is found in the bone marrow, spleen, thymus and lymph nodes. They are capable of amoeboid movement. The white blood cells corpuscles can be grouped into two categories, granulocytes and acronocytes. Okay, acranulocytes and granulocytes. Granulocytes and four or three types, neutrophils and eosinophils and basophils. Okay, neutrophils, eosinophils and basophils. So arachnoids locates these two types, lymphocytes and monocytes. Blood platelets, there are these are small and colorless. They do not have nuclear. There are about 2,50,000. Okay, 2,50,000 by 4,00,000 platelets, cubic millimeter of blood. Life span of platelets 8 to 10 days. They play an important role in clotting of blood. Platelets from clots at the site of injury and prevent blood loss. Okay, it is a function of blood, function of blood transport of respiratory gases, oxygen and carbon dioxide. Okay, transport of digested blood materials to the different body cells. So blood vessels transport nitrogen, excretory product like ammonia, urea and uric acid. It is involved in production of the body and a defense against diseases. Buffer and also helps in regulation pH and body temperature, in maintaining proper water balance in the body. What is blood cells? There are three kinds of blood cells, vessels: arterioles, veins and capillaries. Okay, arterioles, veins and capillaries. Each of these plays very specific role in the circulation process. Arterioles carry oxygenated blood away from the heart. There are grooves on the outside, but they contain smooth interior layer epithelial cells, allows blood to the follow easily. Okay, next one, function of blood cells. Deliver needs materials such as oxygen and glucose to the cells all bodies. Okay, remove wastes product such carbon dioxide. Remove wastes process of carbon dioxide. Next one, fighting diseases by transporting white blood cells. White blood cells, WBC. Okay, the white blood cells throw out the body. Then only, okay, functions of blood cells. Okay, enough this lessons. Okay ma, so circulatory systems, it is a function of very importance. Okay, so human body's circulatory systems, the heart enclosed the double walled are called pericardium. It contains lubricating pericardial fluid, which reduce from friction during heartbeat and products. It is form of mechanical insures. okay. So human heart, external structures of human heart, we can see the in your books, okay. So open types of and closed types, okay. There are two types of systems, open types and closed type, okay. Thank you students, thank you to all. Watch the videos and then only refer this lessons, okay students. We have to learn every day this lessons finished, okay. Next class, unit 13 and unit 4, 14 lesson we have to all students we have to learn, okay. Online classes I ask questions, so preparely for these lessons, okay ma. Thank you, thank you students, thank you to all.